So today we're going to make this Genshin Slime animation in Blender. It's not a full tutorial, just a simple breakdown of it. I rendered it on Lofi with transparent background, standard, very high contrast color. For the base mesh, you only need the UV sphere, make it until it looks like the reference image. Then add subdivision surface modifier. For the electro slime's antenna, you can just delete this vertical, then extrude it to make the antenna shape. Then add UV sphere at the end of the antenna. For the extra object like horn and stones, it's only the simple object. You can make the shape with default cube, with subdivision surface, and mirror it with the base mesh as the mirror object. It's same for the stone. I also add before modifier for it. For the wings, you can make it with plane, then make this shape with this curved bend shape. Then add subdivision surface. Solidify subdivision surface, then mirror it. I'm just using a basic texture paint setup. Go to UV editing, unwrap the mesh with Smart UV Project, set the island margin to 0.05. Go to texture paint, add new texture, base color, name it base color. Multiply the width and the height by 2. Set the color to transparent. For the base color, you can paint it with paint bucket with gradient color. You can just use eyedropper for the color. Then drag it from the top to the bottom. For the pattern, add new image texture, change the color to transparent. Then change the shader to the new image texture to display the new image material. For the pattern, I just trace the pattern from the image reference. I have different reference collection. For the part that I can't really trace, I just paint it manually. You can enable mesh symmetry for the part that have same pattern, so it's mirrored to texture paint. After you're done with texture painting, combine the image texture into one image texture. Then combine that image texture with simple tone shader. You also can add hue saturation node to it if you want to change the saturation or value of the texture. For the outline, add new material. change it into emission material. Choose the color you want. Turn on the backface scaling, then add solidify, set the offset to 1. Normal to flip, material offset to your outline material. Then you can adjust the thickness. For the animation, you need the simple stick. Position your slime. Add bones for each part. Go to boss mode, select the last, then the second last bone. Press Ctrl Shift C, select them track. You also can go to the bone constraint tab to add them track. Repeat the process for all the slime bones. In the bone constraint tab, decrease the influence to 0.5. Go to object mode, select your stick and slime, then the armature. Parent it with automatic weights. You still need to check the vertex group for the slime. Make the slime only react by its bone part. By remove the other bone's vertex group, then add all of it to that one bone. You also need to add loops to the stick. I add subdivision modifier too. You can increase the bendy bones to 5, but this animation doesn't bend that much, so you can ignore it. Then you just need to add rotation keyframe to it. If you want a full tutorial on this bendy bones method, you can watch this tutorial video from Nita Rafalti, link in the description. That's all for today's video. You can download these slime assets and animation in my Patreon page.